Welcome to 3D printer meditation. Let the sound of your printer fill your ears. Follow the extruder's rhythmic movements. Slowly allow your eyes to close. Focus on the motor's humming and the fan's whirring. The extruder's movements are growing dimmer, distant. Far away, you see a pinprick of light. No, a shape, bright with color. It draws closer. You see a title card. Welcome to Void Star Lab, but in a higher plane of abstraction. My name is called Zack Freedman. I swear, one of these days is going to give me a guru meditation error. As I was saying, today we're going to talk about 3D prints to improve your 3D printer. Personally, I use i3 Mark IIIs and a Frozen Sonic Mini 4K. You'll probably find a counterpart to everything I put up here for your hunk of junk of choice. I'm going to repost many of them to things.com in part because it doesn't take 15 minutes to load, unlike a certain other STL website, but mostly because they paid me. That's right, folks. Today's episode is sponsored by Things, the no-nonsense warehouse of free 3D models. I've been working with Things for a while, and they're becoming my go-to place to host and share STL files. They now allow you to post and download entire assemblies of models, and the interactive 3D viewer is buttery smooth, and it loads as fast as the page itself. The spiciest feature is still the geometric search, which lets you upload an STL file and actually search for things that look like it. It's sort of like a reverse image search, but in three dimensions. I'm going to repost every appropriately licensed model I talk about today on Things, so if you want any of them for yourself, you know which description to check. Without further ado, number 10, Railguards. Most of today's consumer-grade 3D printers are made of this aluminum extrusion. Some call it 8020, some call it Maker Beam, some call it X-Stock, V-Slot, T-Slot, hell, some people even call it aluminium, savages. Whatever your preferred nomenclature, you need to start printing these railguards right now. All this crapola has accreted in this crack since I cleaned this thing like mere months ago. But this ends today, and it ends for good. Engage the suck! Now we're gonna slam the door on the dust bunnies by snapping on these rail covers. Not only do these lock out the cruft, they protect the wires running through the channel. I don't want you to get a good look at my sloppy, disgusting crevasses. Gaze too deep into the crevasse, and the crevasse gazes back. Number 9, Prusa Mark IIIs Ultimate Toolbox V2 Modular. That's an emphatic ass name. Having a specific place to put everything is the most effective way to stay organized and make sure you actually, you know, clean up. It's the only way I've found to avert the dreaded piles. You drop in your pliers, scraper, tweezers, caliper, SD cards, apparently infinite number of Allen keys that always seem to be the wrong size the first time you grab one, your alcohol bottle, your Windex bottle, and of course those glue sticks included with your Prusa that I swear are immortal. There's like 6 feet of glue stick in there. Call the SCP Foundation. You can get tool racks like this one for pretty much any printer that has a separate Z rail and frame. You can't like snap a tray to your frame if you know, a thing is riding on it. Just remember that these are large flat prints. Use a brim and clean that bed spotless or you'll get a taco instead of a toolbox. Number 8, Spool Storage Boxes. A while ago, I came up with this brilliant idea for an episode about what to do with your old filament spools. You won't believe what happened next. If you guessed, I accumulated enough empties to overflow an entire recycling bin, a winner is you. This is a great model. The bins are sturdy, but they print really quickly. They have linkages and a handle, so you can stack a bunch of them up into a portable caddy. It includes a drilling guide, because you do need to screw the bins onto the spool. Most importantly, this modeler is a gentleman of class and taste who two shops at Micro Center. One day, I'm gonna write an episode in which I don't have something positive to say about Micro Center. Notice me, senpai. Number 7, Extruder Spinner Power Hour. An extruder spinner is a little dingus with a tiny magnet on the end. You stick that bit to your extruder motor shaft, and as your printer prints, your extruder extrudes and spins the spinner. So you get an entire, wait, I just stopped writing mid-sentence. The Extruder Gyroscope by Jeeping Johnny gives you the joy of gimbal lock with every print. This thing astoundingly prints in one piece, but tumbles freely on three axes as it turns. Bravo, Jeeping Johnny. Jeep off into the sunset, you Jeeping legend, you. The wind-up key visualizer by Printer Guy 74 is exactly what it says in the tin. I think it's funny, Printer Guy 74 thinks it's funny, and frankly, your opinion doesn't matter. The Kinetic Extruder Visualizer engine by Knickers is a delightfully intricate functional piston engine for your squirty chooser. Download the SCAD files to generate new engines of your own. It's an engine engine! The Sillywalks Extruder Visualizer by Lecter is one of the nerdiest things I have ever printed. If you get the joke, you better fill my comment section with references because us intellectuals are a dying breed. The Extruder Rotation Pirate Wheel by Lamisky adds some salty sea flavor to your printar. I used to have one of these things on my crotch. It was driving me nuts. Number 6. Hang on a second, we're halfway through the video and I haven't called you to a single action. Like, comment, subscribe, turn notifications, join our Discord, join it on Patreon, follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter, watch my playlist, watch my episodes, come back every week, but mostly have a lovely day. Number 6, Spool Holder and Dry Box for Enclosure V2 by Andre Stryetsky. That's a lot of consonants. A dry box is a mostly airtight enclosure with a tray of desiccant that sucks moisture out of the air. All filaments will take on moisture over time, and as it moistens, printing it can cause bubbles, pops, it splits apart, it becomes brittle or dull. Most makers don't have to worry about wet filament because in most climates, PLA takes like a year to take damage and PETG takes like 3 or 6 months. But if you're printing with TPU, polycarbonate, or especially nylon, this is serious business. These filaments can become waterlogged and worthless in mere hours. If you're gonna do a long print, you're gonna need a dry box. This is a big ass print, but the results are just a super crispy box that keeps your filament super crispy. And it has the readout to prove it. You can make a bunch of these to nest nicely into a wall-mountable storage rack. This one is going to get some use soon because Prusa sent me a fancy spool of polycarbonate, and I cannot wait to completely fail to print Nerf blasters with it. Number 5. LED Light Bar Prusa i3 Mark II Mark III. It's weird that so few modern printers come with lights pre-installed. These brackets replace the Z-axis stabilizer things on your Prusa with these nice wide arms that support aluminum flat stock. You mount your LED strips to the metal, you run the wires through the hollow arms, you optionally add a power switch if you so desire, and a switching regulator if your strips are 12 volts, and you just power that straight off the Prusa's PSU. I took mine a little further by running a wire from the switching regulator's enable pin to the unused IO pin 76 on the Rambo board. That means I can control my lights with G-code. It's pretty spiffy, huh? Number 4. Longer, girthier i3 spool holder by FFF technology. You know what? I'm gonna read the designer's description of this item because, like, it's art. I'm not doing any better than this. Many i3 clones come up with a short, unimpressive spool holder that can't even perform with the big boys. They seem to only hold 500 gram spools, but let's face it, fellas, you want it longer, you want it thicker, you want it to perform all night long. With our spool holder, that's no longer a pipe dream. Many other designs work, but they all seem to have trade-offs that make them a hassle, from huge usage of material to complicated designs that we would like to do without. But FFF Tech comes to the rescue again, folks. Our insipid engineers mimic the original in that it's a screw and nut system, but with length and girth. We printed this in black because, well, if you haven't noticed, we almost always print in black. Don't you judge me, but you can print it any color you want, from is that mayo on your crotch white, all the way to I got an itch down there, Doc, red. So stop playing with 500 grams of unpleasurable disappointment. Print a better spool holder today. Number 3, Fart Fighter 5000 by yours truly. I found myself in a dilemma when I did the 3D&D episode. I had to print a ton of resin, but it was just too cold to open any windows and an air filter wasn't available. So I grabbed some parts from the Fab Lab and I whacked together the Fart Fighter 5000. The Fart Fighter is a chamber full of activated charcoal contained by two foam sandwich filters. I put a spare PC case fan on both ends, I mounted it in a storage bin, and there you go, filtered enclosure for the printer or the cleanup. This configuration worked perfectly for me, but the flexible plates on rails construction lets you create the optimal filter of your dreams. I made an adapter to attach a hose in the outlet, but you could just slap that on the intake side instead to free up space. Is it Taco Tuesday? Stick that hose up to a chair. Consider the Fart Fighter 5000 your build-your-own solution kit to discreetly contain your most malodorous miasmas. Number 2, 3D Benchy. You've certainly seen this one before, but can you imagine a more iconic print for your printer? Hardcore vets of 3D printing use this model for barging rights, but I gotta think that every maker should be able to run off a fairly decent Benchy. Of course, I've gondola extreme and printed the biggest Benchy you kayaks for. Some sailor, the Benchy is junk. I think it's cutterly adorable and it just tugboat strings of my heart. Don't forget that this is still a testing tool. It's great to monitor your rigging, fix sloopy bridging, and generally spot problem schooner. It prints fast so you can tweak dinghies rafterwards and trawler again. Boat! Number 1 is... Boo! You already did a video on the tiny gaming PC. Boo!
It's not the tiny gaming PC, it's the software running on the tiny gaming PC.
Number 1 is OctoPrint.
Boo! Software isn't 3D printed. Boo!
Ah, fine, geez. Here's a 3D printed case that mounts the Pi to the printer's dashboard. You happy now?
Just put a Raspberry Pi Zero inside the printer. Boo!
OctoPrint might not be 3D printed and it might not be spicy and new, but a well-configured instance running on the right hardware is the single biggest improvement you can make to your printer. OctoPrint is a super slick print server that runs on a Raspberry Pi, or another, it doesn't have to be a Pi, but you know. You can install a webcam and have a computer vision AI babysit your prints. You can have it automatically refactor jagged curves into smooth arcs. My personal favorite is something you see in almost every video. The Octolapse library makes gorgeous time lapses easy by automatically moving the extruder to the same place every layer. Don't run OctoPrint on a Pi Zero, it's just too weak. I know there's a special place to install it on the Prusa, but looky here. The Zero takes far longer to print, it's way laggier, and the processor is overloaded just running it to the point where I get layer shifts. Just remember, use a bigger SD card than you're used to. You want to have lots of headroom to store all those tasty time-lapse photos. Sadly, our jaunt through the most meta of 3D prints draws near, for your printer has gone silent. Its work has ended, and your new creation is complete. Slowly now, allow your eyes to open, let your vision clear, and behold what your printer has made real. Cosmic thanks to Things for sponsoring this episode. Use the links in the description to download these models and check out their slick 3D previews for yourself. A hearty namaste to our Patreon patrons whose generous contributions, well, keep Voidstar Lab afloat. Our enlightened lab assistants are Roger Pinkham, Daniel Cadwell, The Antifa, Olivier Yipton. This is a cry for help, please. I am trapped. This is not just a funny Patreon meme. Seriously, send help, oh God, send help, please. Michael Dunn, Azundo, Salty, Gregory Jones, Anthony Mincarelli, Brian Santero, Jason, Acalia, Sam Wampler, James Berry, Zanforian, Rusty Flute, Bill Schuller, Varka, Tech Daddy, Robert Burris, Powerful CCH, Taranak, and Sir Derpington of Derptopia. The highest plane of thanks to our collaborators. I'm not Betacore, CMD Command. I've hidden their mystical names somewhere in this episode, though not in this particular scene. That's a little too meta, even for this dimension. Finally, thanks to my beloved life partner behind the camera, Brooke, and to our insightful Discord mods, My Fair Julie, Techniac, and Billy Rubin. Brooke and I are currently moving from New York City to Colorado, as in right now, as you watch this. I hear they have machines that wash dishes for you, and machines that wash clothes for you, and they have them right there in your own home. It's astonishing. Thank you for watching me, thank you, and I'll see you in the future's future. Kill 'em. Kill 'em.